Morning, viewers. Welcome to the session devotionals for this morning. Our guest of God will be looking at the topic, Believe Your Great Exploit Dreams. Believe Your Great Exploit Dreams, under the series, The Reality of Great Exploit. Host my humble self, Dr. K. Text taken from the book of Mark chapter 9 from verse 19 down to 25. But let's pray before we begin. Heavenly Father, come say thank you for the bread and the nurseries. We come to hear from you this morning. Father, we ask, speak to us and grant us understanding. Your word says, 2 Peter 1:3, according to your divine power, you've given us all things that pertain to life and godliness through the knowledge of your word. Grant us the knowledge of your word this morning and grace to see great exploit in our lives. For in Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Topic one more time. Believe your great exploit dreams. Under the series, The Reality of Great Exploit, host my humble self, look at key text taken from the book of Mark chapter 9 from verse 19 down to 25. Let's read from verse 19. Said, he answered him and said, O faithless generation, how long shall I be with you? How long shall I suffer you? Bring him unto me. And verse 23, Jesus said unto him, if thou canst believe, all things are possible to him that believeth. I take that again for emphasis. Verse 23, Jesus said unto him, if thou canst believe, all things are possible to him that what? That believeth. And it was 24. And straight away the father of the child cried out and said with tears, Lord, I believe, help my unbelief. Verse 25. Of course, Jesus rebuked the foul spirit, saying unto him, thou dumb and deaf spirit, I charge you, come out of him and enter no more. And certainly it was so. May the Lord bless his word and grant his understanding in Jesus. And further reading, Genesis chapter 11 from verse 1 down to 7. And the whole earth was of one language and one speech. And it came to pass as the journey in verse 2 from the east, they found a plain in the land of Samaria. And they dwelt there in verse 3. And he said one to another, go to, let us make bricks and burn them thoroughly. And they had bricks for stones and slime they had for the mortar. And in verse 4, and they said, go to, let us build us a city and a tower, whose top may reach unto heaven, and let us make us a name, lest we be scattered abroad upon the face of the whole earth. And in verse 5, and the Lord came down to see the city and the tower, which the children of men builded. And in verse 6, and the Lord said, behold, the people is one, and they have all one language, and this they begin to do. That means this they believe, and they begin to do. And now nothing will be restrained from them, which they have imagined to do. And of course, God came and change their language, and of course, the mission wasn't accomplished. But the lesson to pick out from it is that they believed that they could build a city that, of course, the tower would get to heaven, and they began doing it, and they almost accomplished that which they began. I pray that which you imagine to do, I see God granting you the grace to get it done in Jesus. In Genesis chapter 15, verse 1 to 7, after this, in the word of the Lord came unto Abraham in a vision, saying, fear not, Abraham, I am thy shield and the exceeding great reward. And he brought him forward abroad and said, look now towards heaven and tell the stars, if thou be able to number them. And he said unto him, so shall thy seed be. And in verse 6, and he believed, and he believed in the Lord, and he counted it to him for righteousness. I take verse 6 again forever. And he believed in the Lord, and it counted it to him for righteousness. And he said unto him, I am the Lord that brought thee out of Ur of the Chaldeans to give thee this land to inherit it. I see your belief coming to lamplight in Jesus. In Habakkuk chapter 2 from verse 1 to 3, he said, I will stand upon my watch and set me upon the tower, and will watch to see what you see unto me, and what I shall answer when I am reproved. And in verse 2, and the Lord answered me and said, write a vision and made it plain upon tables, that he may run the reader it. And verse 3, for the vision is yet for an appointed time, but at the end it shall speak and not lie. Do it tarry, wait for it, because it will surely come to pass, it will not tarry. I pray, God of heaven, will bring all your belief to reality in Jesus' name. Mark chapter 11, from verse 12 down to 24, our last for last reading, said, and on the morrow, he came from Bethany. He was hungry. He saw a fig tree. He went to get fruit of it. There was nothing. And Jesus cursed the fig tree. He said in verse 14, Jesus said unto him, no man eat fruit of thee hereafter. And the disciples had him. And in verse 19, and when evening was coming out of the city, they were passing by that same fig tree. And in verse 21, and Peter, calling to remembrance, said unto him, Master, behold, the fig tree which thou cursest is withered away. And in verse 22, and Jesus answered and said unto them, have faith in God. That means believe in God. In verse 20, for verily I say unto you, that whosoever shall say unto this mountain, be that removed and be that cast into the sea, and shall not doubt in his heart, but shall believe that those things which he said shall come to pass, he shall have whatsoever he said. Not what he prayed, what he said. So anything you say is as powerful as what you pray. I see you confessing and believing positive things, and I see them coming to reality in your life in Jesus' name. Topic one more time. Believe your great exploit dreams. Believe in your great exploit dreams. Under the series, The Reality of Great Exploit. Host my humble self, like I say. Text taken from the book of Mark, chapter 9, from verse 19 down to 25. For further reading, Genesis 11, 1-7, Genesis 15, 1-7, Hebrews 2, 1-3, and Mark, chapter 11, from verse 12 to 24. Please, at your free time, you can read all of these Bible passages again, and I'm sure you're going to be blessed, because God will speak to you through them in Jesus' name. Thinking cap, a mind-blowing word for this morning is, what you don't self-believe, you can never become. I'll take it again. What you don't self-believe, you can never become. Think about this. Today we'll look at a topic, believe in your great exploit dreams, on our teaching series on the reality of great exploit. By way of introduction, let's understand that great exploit is real. It's never a mirage, because many people have worked in its reality as a lifestyle. However, we must recognize and appreciate the fact that great exploit begins with a self-faith. With a what? Self-faith and belief in its reality. David did not just run to the battlefield to confront Goliath, but first believed that his God is able to disconfigure Goliath. He believed that the God who made him destroy a lion and a bear would deliver the Goliath into his hand. And we saw him went into that battle and came out victorious. Talking about Nehemiah, same with Nehemiah. He believed that they could rebuild the burned city. And a man came, believing that, and they began the rebuilding, and in just 52 days, Nehemiah chapter 6 verse 15, that project was accomplished. Beloved, let's believe that God is able to grant us great exploit testimonies. And on this note, we will learn about how to believe our great exploit dreams to reality. At the end of this 10-minute chat, I see you believing, not only believing, I see you converting your belief into reality in Jesus' name. Exodus chapter 14. From verse 26, 29, and the Lord said unto Moses, stretch out thy hand over the sea, that the waters may come again upon the Egyptians, upon their chariot and upon their horsemen. The man did not doubt, and he did that. And verse 27, and Moses stretched forth his hand over the sea. I mean, he believed God, that God is able to do what you say. And we saw every one of the Egyptians being destroyed. In Daniel chapter 3, from verse 16 to 30, Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego answered and said to the king, oh, Nebuchadnezzar, we are not careful to answer in this matter. Verse 17, if it be so, our God whom we serve is able to deliver us from the burning furnace, and he will certainly deliver us from your hand, O king. Said in verse 18, but if not, be it known unto the king, O king, that we will not serve thy God, nor worship the golden image which thou hast set up. And in verse 19, then was Nebuchadnezzar full of fury, and form of his visage was changed against Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. Therefore he spoke and commanded that they should heat the furnace 7 times more than it was. And they did that. Even the guys who threw them into the fiery furnace, they were burned alive. But these guys were gallantly walking inside the fire. They were not hurt. All because they believed that God is able to deliver them. And of course, God did that. I pray your belief will not fail you going forward in Jesus. And everything you trust God for. I see the God of Isaac, the God of Abraham, bringing those things you believe to reality in Jesus' name. Matthew chapter 8, from verse 6 down to 10. And many, Lord, and saying, Lord, my servant lieth at home, sick of palsy, grievously tormented. And Jesus said unto him, I will come and heal him. And the centurion answered and said, Lord, I am not worthy that thou shouldest come under my roof, but speak that word only, and my servant shall be healed. For I am a man under authority, as I have soldiers under me. I said, this one go, he come. I said, this one come, he come. He said, speak the word only, and my servant shall be made whole. And in verse 10, when Jesus had it, he marveled and said to that fellow him, said, verily I say unto you, I have not found so great faith, not in Israel. And of course, in that same hour, the servant of the man was made whole, because Jesus said, be unto you according to your faith. And of course, the servant was made whole, all because the master believed that when Jesus speak the word, the servant will be healed. In Matthew chapter 9, verse 27 to 30, and when Jesus departed, 10 to blind men follow him, crying, saying, thou son of David, have mercy on us. And in verse 28, and he came to the house, the blind men came to him. Jesus said unto them, believe ye that I am able to do this? They said, yeah, Lord, we believe. That he touched their eyes, according to their faith be unto you. And the eyes was open straight away. I pray, whatever you believe and whatever you trust God for, whatever you have faith in God for, the God of Abraham will bring it to pass in your life, in Jesus' name. We've been trying to look at this subtopic. What's the reality of great exploit? What's the reality of great? Is it real? Of course it is real. We walk on believing the testimonies and acts of great exploit, which you saw yesterday. And today we're looking at what's the reality of great exploit when we walk on believing our great exploit dreams. So it's real when we walk on the reality of believing on our great exploit dreams. So what's the reality of great exploit? Believing your great exploit dreams. When we walk on believing on our great exploit dreams, then we will see the reality of great exploit. I pray you will see the reality of great exploit in your life, in Jesus. And that dream that you believe, that dream that you hold on to, I see Jehovah bring it to lamplight in Jesus' name. So we're looking at what's the reality of great exploit. It is real when we walk on believing our great exploit dreams. This simply is being absolutely positive in one's dreams, positive in one's determinations, and positive in one's pursuit towards great exploit. I see your great exploit coming to lamplight in Jesus and Matthew. Daniel chapter 3 from verse 16 to 30, we see Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego walking out of the fiery furnace because they believe that God is able to deliver them. And of course, God did that. They walked out of that fiery furnace gallantly, and they were not hurt. Of course, in Matthew chapter 9, from verse 19 down to 25 also, you can see the account of what belief granted to the children of Israel. Also, in Mark chapter 11, from verse 12 down to 24 also, you can see the acts of the Lord at work there. So anytime you believe God, God never fails. Anytime you trust God, God will always bring his word and his miracle to pass. Mark chapter 9 from verse 25 said, he answered and said, "Oh, faithless generation, how long shall I be with you? How long shall I suffer you?" Said, "Bring him to me." And Jesus said unto him, "If thou canst believe, all things are possible to him that believeth." And straightway the father of the child cried and said, "I believe." And Jesus rebuked the false spirit, and he was made whole. In Mark chapter 11 from verse 12 down to 24. And on the morrow, when he were come from Bethany, he was hungry. He saw a fig tree. He caused a fig tree. And the following day they were coming. The fig tree was already dried up. And Jesus said to them, "For verily I say unto you, that whatsoever ye shall say, whosoever shall say unto this mountain, be that removed and be that cast into the sea, and shall not doubt in his heart, said he shall have. But shall believe that those in which he said shall come to pass, say he shall have whatsoever he said. Therefore I say unto you, verse 24, what things soever ye desire, believe, when ye pray, say, believe, and ye shall receive them." I see all your dreams coming to reality in Jesus' name. Remember, we're looking at what's the reality of great exploit. And we said, when we walk on believing on our dreams for great exploit, then certainly we're going to see its reality. We said it's simply being absolutely positive in one's dream, positive in one's determination, positive in one's pursuit towards great exploit. Can read Daniel chapter 3 from verse 16 to 30. Can read Matthew chapter 9 from verse 19 to 25. And you can read Mark chapter 11 from verse 12 to 24. More to all of who said, this also is holding on. This also is holding on to one's what? Holding on to one's dream. This also is holding on to one's great exploit dreams in God with a continuous, diligent, positive works to match till the realization of say, there's also this one holding on to his great exploit dreams in God with a continuous, diligent, positive works to match till the realization of say, I see all your dreams coming to reality in Jesus' name. Genesis chapter 26 from verse 1 down to 23. We see Isaac there, God telling him not to go to the land of Egypt. He should stay where he will show him. And of course, he dwelt in the land of Gerar. And a man sowed in that year, and he reaped 100-fold. And he was dangerously blessed that the whole nation came and envied him. And of course, they began to afflict him. The well that they dug during his father, Abraham, the people, Philistines, came and poured earth in there. He left there, dug another well. They came here again, covered it, went again about 6 different places until he went to Beersheba, and he was able to find water there. And there nobody struck with him. And 1 Samuel chapter 17 from verse 32 down to 54, we saw a Goliath and a David, a little child, a teen who confronted a great Goliath. He brought him down, all because he believed that God is able to grant him victory, because the same God granted him victory against the lion and against the bear. I see God bringing all your dreams to reality in Jesus' name. Matthew chapter 9 from verse 27 down to 30. Matthew chapter 9 from verse 27 to 30. Of course, we see the acts of the Lord also. Jesus spoke a miracle and it came to pass immediately. I pray all your dreams, none will fail in Jesus' name. Jesus told the blind man, he said, did you believe that I'm able to heal you? They said, yes, we believe. And he touched their eyes, said, be unto you according to your faith. And their eyes was open immediately. In summary of all we're trying to say, we're looking at what's the reality of great exploit. And we said, it works on our belief, on our great exploit dreams. We went further to say this also is one holding on to his great exploit dreams in God with a continuous diligent positive work to match till the realization of saving. Currently, Genesis chapter 26, verse 1 to 23, 1 Samuel chapter 17, 36 to 54, Matthew 9, 27 to 30. Lastly, beloved, let's know that achieving great exploit in life begins with a total belief in your dream through God, because what you don't believe, you can't become. It's a theory in life that nothing extraordinary is ever accidental. I take that again. It's a theory in life that nothing extraordinary is accidental. Meaning, every great feat or every great exploit you see is someone else's dream that was converted to reality. However, before you can convert your dreams to reality, you must first be a child of God. That means you must accept Jesus to be your Lord and your Savior. And as such, I implore you to accept and confess Jesus today in truth and in spirit. If you want your dreams to be converted to reality, then you must be a child of God, because God is only committed to bring the dream of only his children to pass. And in Mark chapter 1 verse 15 said, and saying, the time is fulfilled and the kingdom of God is at hand, repent ye and believe the gospel. And I tell you, believe the gospel and certainly your dreams will come to pass. Mark 16:16-19, he that believe and is baptized shall be saved, but he that believe not shall be damned. Said, and this chant I follow them that believe in my name, they shall cast out devils, they shall speak with new tongues. How can they take any deadly thing, shall not hurt them. In Romans 12 verse 2 said, and be not conformed to this world, but be transformed by the renewing of your mind, that ye may prove what is that good and acceptable and the perfect will of God. So if you want a renewing of your mind so that whatever you believe in your mind will come to limelight, then say yes to Jesus. Place your hand in your chest and repeat this prayer after me. Jesus, I come to you this morning as a sinner, forgive me my sins. I know you come to this earth for my sake, you died. On the third day you rose again for my freedom. Right now, Jesus, I confess you to be my Lord and my Savior. Renew my mind and cause me to believe great things and great feet in life. And Lord, as I believe them, grant me grace to walk them and to convert them to reality. For in Jesus' name I pray. Amen. Take two prayers for prayer. Father, empower my dreams that I believe to reality in Jesus' name. Isaiah chapter 34 verse 16 said, seek ye out of the book of the Lord and read. No one of this shall fail. None shall want her made, for my mouth has commanded it, and the Spirit have gathered with this understanding. Father, empower my dreams that I believe to reality in Jesus' name. Father, empower my dreams that I believe to reality in Jesus. This is my petition this morning. Hear me, O God. Empower my dreams that I believe to reality in Jesus' name. Last prayer. Father, empower many saints in Nigeria to believe in their dreams and abilities and empower same to reality even in this nation in Jesus' name. In Joshua chapter 21 verse 45, there fail not aught of any good thing which the Lord have spoken unto the house of Israel. All came to pass. I see all your dreams coming to pass in Jesus' name. Father, empower many Nigerians to believe in their dreams and abilities and empower same to reality even in this nation. Thank you for his done. For in Jesus' name we pray. Join me, pray this prayer, share this gospel, and be blessed. God bless you. See you tomorrow. I pray that this day shall be a day of God's favor for you. Thank you for being online. God bless you in Jesus.